Welcome students to the video solutions of pre-NEET mock test number 1. This is for chemistry. Students, before starting, we have to discuss one thing, that initially there were 45 questions in chemistry in the paper of NEET, but now onwards there will be 50 questions, and those 50 questions are divided into two sections, that is section A and section B. In section A there are 35 questions, and in section B there are 15 questions. When we talk about section A, you have to attempt all the 35 questions. That means all the questions are mandatory. But when we talk about section B, out of those 15 questions, you only have to attempt 10 questions. That means you people have a choice for 5 questions. So let's start with the video solutions of section A, moving towards the first question, that is question number 51. So let's read the question, students. The calculated spin-only magnetic moment of Mn2 plus Ir is. Students, in this question, we have to answer the calculated spin-only magnetic moment of a particular ion, that is Mn2 plus. So before starting, first of all, we need to know the formula to calculate magnetic moment. And here I'm writing it. Magnetic moment, which is mu, the symbol used is mu, and the formula used is under root n plus 2. Bm is Bohr's magneton. So student, what is N here? N is number of unpaired electrons. So now we have to calculate the number of unpaired electrons in Mn2+. So Mn has atomic number 25. That means argon 4s2 3d5. But here Mn is in plus 2 oxidation state. So Mn plus 2 is equals to argon and 3d5. That means there are 5 unpaired electrons. So the value of N is equals to 5. Now we can calculate the value of magnetic moment under root 5 plus 2, which is under root 5 7, which is equals to under root 35. That is equals to 5.92 bm. So the correct answer is option number 2. The value 4.90 is when the value of N is 4. The value of magnetic moment 2.84 is when the number of unpaired electrons is 2. And the value of magnetic moment is 3.87 when the value of N, that is number of unpaired electrons, is 3. So here we got our correct answer, which is option number 2. Moving to the next question, students, which is question number 52. Let's read it. Match the following and identify the correct option. Students, in this question, we are given with two columns. First of all, we have to match and then identify the correct code. So let's start with number 1, A. Here it is given CO gaseous plus N2 gaseous. Students, CO plus N2 is known as producer gas. The mixture of CO and N2 is known as producer gas. So for A, the correct code is 3. Moving to next. Permanent hardness of water. Students, we know that the permanent hardness of water is due to the presence of calcium and magnesium in the form of chlorides and sulfates in water. That means for B, the correct code is 1. This. Moving to next, CH4. Students, CH4 is an electron precise hydride, since we can see that here carbon is surrounded with 8 electrons. Therefore, CH4 is an electron precise hydride. So for C, the correct code is number 2. Moving to next, that is D, which is B2H6. Student, B2H6 is a Lewis acid, as it is an electron deficient species. So for D, the correct code is 4. So we can identify the correct option. The correct option is option number 3. For A, it's 3. For B, it's 1. For C, it's 2, and for D, it's 4. That means the correct answer is option number 3. Moving to the next question, students, which is question number 53. Let's read it. The mixture which shows negative deviation from Raoult's law is. Students, before starting this question, first of all, we have to understand that what kind of mixtures show negative deviation from Raoult's law and what kind of mixtures show positive deviation from Raoult's law. So let's assume A mixture consists of two components, that is A and B. So if the intermolecular forces of attraction that exist between AA and BB are weaker than that exist between AB, then that particular mixture will show negative deviation from Raoult's law. And if the intermolecular forces of attraction that exist between AA and BB are stronger than that exist between AB, then that particular mixture will exhibit positive deviation from Raoult's law. So let's start with option number one. Student, in case of acetone and aniline, there exists hydrogen bonding. As a result, the intermolecular forces between acetone and aniline is stronger. So the mixture shows negative deviation from Raoult's law. So the correct answer is option number one. But still, moving towards the next options, benzene and toluene, this shows ideal behavior. That means this forms ideal solution, and the rest two, that is benzene plus acetone and ethanol plus water, shows positive deviation from Raoult's law. That means the correct answer is option number one. Moving towards the next question, students, let's read it. Identify the correct statement among the following. Students, in this question, we are given with four statements and we have to identify the correct one. Students, but before starting this question, I have to tell you that this paper is really beneficial for you people, because this paper is completely based upon the paper that came in 2020. So each and every question is valuable for you. So let's start. Number one, copper mat contains high percentage of copper as Cu2O. Student, I hope you know that this is an incorrect statement, since copper mat, here I'm writing, copper mat contains Cu2S and FeS. So moving to the next statement, vapor phase refining is carried out for nickel by Mohn's process. Student, this is the correct statement, as vapor phase refining involves Mohn's process as well as Van Arkel method. Mohn's process is used for the refining of nickel, and Van Arkel method is used for the refining of titanium as well as zirconium. Now let us discuss Mohn's process. In case of Mohn's process, first of all, impure nickel is heated in a steam of carbon monoxide to give a complex nickel tetracarbonyl, which is further subjected to higher temperature to decompose to give pure nickel. Now let us write the equation. So first of all, here it is impure nickel, 4 carbonyl, the temperature taken is 330 Kelvin to 350 Kelvin. The complex so formed is this. This is a volatile complex. This complex is further subjected to higher temperature, which is 450 Kelvin to 470 Kelvin, to give pure nickel. This nickel is pure. Moving to the next statement, students, percentage of carbon in pig iron is about 1%. Student, this is again an incorrect statement, as the percentage of carbon in pig iron is approximately 4%. Moving to next, cast iron is the purest form of iron. Students, this is also an incorrect statement, as wrought iron is the purest form of iron rather than cast iron. That means the correct statement is option number two. Moving towards the next question, students. Chocolate brown precipitate A is formed when aqueous CuSO4 reacts with K4FeCN6. What is the formula of A from the following? Students, I'm writing the reaction here. CuSO4 reacts with K4FeCN6. Here I'm taking 2 moles of CuSO4. The compounds so formed is Cu2FeCN6. This is A. This is chocolate brown precipitate. Along with that, the side product so obtained is K2SO4. That means the correct answer is option number 4. Moving towards the next question, students.